From my recollection, Oakley started with Jim Gennard. He was frustrated going to school and decided not to do that. Had a lot of great ideas. He was always quite a visionary. And how he actually got involved in taking all of his knowledge and beginning off with BMX grips, I don't know that exactly, but I know that's what he did. My name is Mike Bell. I am a former AMA Supercross champion. I started to work at Oakley after my motocross career ended in 1983. Started here in 1985 and came in through the promotions department. Greg Arnett and I were the whole, in today's terms, sports marketing department. And it was a lot of fun. When I came to work at Oakley, we were still a grip company, but we weren't evolving anymore. The B2 and the B1B were the grips of choice at the time, and we did a lot of different color combinations, and you know, which ultimately kind of transformed into where the blades and even the eye shades, where you know we brought in new unique colors, and you can mix and match different pieces. You know, it was more of a modular product. Before, everybody was just one solid color. You just molded a grip and, you know, just one color. And so it was pretty cool the way that Jim had developed the sleeve for those. But I think all of the injection molding and that process, I really think that that's what motivated Jim to do the eyewear, you know, with starting out with goggles, and then as it transformed into the eyewear. When I started in 85, we were really a grip and goggle company with some belief that we could do some cool eyewear. Even when I came on board and we were doing promotion, our premier athletes were Stu Thompson, R.L. Osborne, BMXers. They were still some of the highest paid, you know, actually some of the only athletes that were being compensated. BMX was a huge sport at the time. In the mid 70s, I mean, BMX was huge. It was unbelievable. I mean, the riders, these guys were all driving 930 Porsches, and these guys were making great money. And it was a great time. And Jim knew that these guys were, you know, image leaders, wanted to make products for them, and that's what we did. Because even after Jim got frustrated with all the litigation surrounding the grips, you know, we got ripped off by some well-known companies as well as some offshore companies. Just, you know, the patent infringement, even if the patents were kind of loose, was really frustrating to Jim. That's when he did the first goggle. But even then, even though the goggle wasn't successful as a goggle, he had so much support from the BMX industry, because that's when that whole trend of riders wearing their goggles on the helmet started. And if you look back, you know, in the BMX history, you'll see riders on the line with the goggles on their helmet sitting on top of their visor, and they never pulled them down onto their face. For Jim to still believe in the goggle and go and just say, you know, hey Stu, could you just run these on your helmet? I'll give you $10 or whatever, you know? I'll detail your car for you, whatever it would have been. He got people to do that. And then people bought those goggles, put them on their helmet, and never put them on their face. And that was enough money to fund the O-frame goggle, which is, I'm sure, still the most profitable, one of the most profitable products in the company's history. When Jim started Oakley, probably a few thousand dollars a year, you know, obviously not profitable in the first years, to now a company that does over $1 billion a year in sales. But the interesting thing is that as long as I've known Jim, that wasn't the goal. That wasn't what he was after. He was really trying to develop great products. Something that he was proud of, something we were all proud of. There was never a dollar goal. It was always a product goal. It was always, you know, where we would be and how we would support our athletes. He wasn't bullshitting us. It wasn't about us helping him reach his goal. We were all in it together. It was just so much fun. Whether we succeeded or we failed, it was always in the effort. Because not everything that Jim ever touched was a complete success. But he learned as much from his failures, like we all do, maybe more, than from the successes.
All that I know is I'm falling.